So today I will talk about exploiting a feature store for graphs on Neo4j. And for sure the first thing to do is to talk a little about machine learning operation to understand why a feature store can be useful and why it could be very useful to add a feature store on Neo4j. I'm quite sure that many of you know something about machine learning operation. And in general, machine learning operation is the series of steps and operations that you have to care about to offer value to the user. Because nowadays, the focus is changing from model-centric AI. So we have done a lot of research in creating better models and so on. And now we are talking about data-centric AI, because we have seen that if you work on data, if you create a good machine learning operation pipelines, a good loop, that you can test your model, you can see how your model perform, and so you can work on enrich your data, prepare better your data, is better, because you will reach sooner better performances than working on the model, creating complex model and so on. This is the idea on why now we are talking more and more about data-centric AI and machine learning operation. And yeah, we are so understood that a model is for sure an AI model in general, machine learning model, an algorithm and so on is the starting point of AI, because if you want to offer real value to the user, you have to care about the data and the model, because in AI in general, in data science in general, data and the model, the algorithms is are two indivisible parts. So we have the one general machine learning pipeline, and we start with the data analysis, some descriptive analysis, and some other. Now it works. I don't know if before it working. So. Ah, okay. We have some data analysis step where we try to understand if there are some data missing. We have to do some work with the data. Then we do many data science experiments. We create models, we test that models, we try to fine-tune some of these models and see how it performs in a test environment. Then for sure we have a source repository where we share our code and our text. Then we have to create the first pipeline to share our code and to share our findings in the data experiment. We have a data engineering step, because now here we have to have some automated pipelines, because all the data engineering steps that we have done during the data science experiment, we have to be done also in production. Because if the model was trained on some data, you have to recreate that data in production. So we have to automate the data engineering steps that we have performed during the data science experiments. We have maybe to do some model, ML model engineering. We have to load our model in a model registry. Doing so, we can serve that model with a prediction service, an API, and so on. Then, very important is to monitor the performance of our model, and then we will have that our model will degrade during the time, so we have to trigger our retraining step to have our model updated with our data. And as we can see, there is a component, the feature store, that can help us to connect the data science experiment, data science development phase, to the machine learning operation phase. So, For sure, today we will focus on Neo4j and Fissure Store. I don't know if some of you already know Fissure Store or have already worked with some Fissure Store, but yeah, for sure, Fissure Store simplifies the following. One, it's quite simple, storage and management of the fissure. This is quite simple to imagine that a Fissure Store helps us to store the fissure. One concept, an important concept, is a timed management of the same fissure type, because we can create multiple versions of our fissure, and it's important to keep track of the version of the fissure we are using, because if we give as input another fissure, another version of the fissure into our model, maybe we will degrade the performance of the model, and so on. Well, for sure, fissure retrieve at train and inference phases. We have to transform our raw data through the execution of data pipelines. That is optional, because not all the fissure store offer this fissure, and search and discover fissure to find a new fissure, to find new way to create new fissures in general. This is the data life cycle, and we can see how different roles work with a fissure store. We have the data engineer, data scientist, and machine learning engineer. That the first one, the data engineer, define and iterate on new feature. So it read from feature store and write in the feature store new feature. The data scientist mainly load the data from the feature store to train its model and so on. And the machine learning engineer load the feature data for testing, to test the infrastructure and so on. The prediction service will need to compute fissure values for inference. So we during the prediction service, the model can create the predictions, the inferences, and so on. We need to log the served fissures, the prediction, and the outcome. And we have to track stats to identify issues in general. And the last step is we need to monitor for drift and quality issue. There are two concepts about drift, the concept drift and the data drift, that we need to pay attention, because during the time some data drift is it's quite simple to be presented in our system. FIST, we are using FIST, is a mainly because it's open source. There are many feature store, but FIST is one of them that is open source. It's supported by many companies. One of them is Google. One of the major partners is for sure Google. FIST supports data source in all major clouds. And this is the architecture of FIST, where we store, transform, serve, and validate and monitor our feature. But we will see better in the following slide the logical architecture. So FIST help us to create the features. That step, we will see that step using Neo4j. We will load the feature created in the offline store. With FIST materialized, we can move the last version of the feature into the online store. Then we have the get historical features to train the model with the feature at some time. And then we can deploy the model and using get online feature to create our prediction and our inference in the prediction service. So there are just four concepts to take in mind with feature store. There is the data source. The data source refers to raw underlying data. For instance, a table in Postgres. The entity is semantically related feature. Point in time data, FIST uses a time series data model to represent data. And the feature view is an object that represents a logical group of time series data, of time series feature data, as you can as they are in the raw data source. So this is an example. We have a driver. With the driver ID, we represent the entity. Rating is a feature, for instance. We have the feature value that is 4.2 for the driver ID with driver ID 1004, the entity value, and we have the timestamp. We can have multiple feature for the same driver with different timestamp. So we have different version of the same features in general. Okay, we are now starting to see the connecting point between FIST and Neo4j. We know with the graph data science in general, we have many ways to create feature from a graph on Neo4j. One of it is the properties in nodes and relationship are for sure features that we can use in our machine learning algorithm model and so on. We can create features with graph data science using PageRank, betweenness, and so on. They can be added to the node or they can be used as feature. We have also many node embedding algorithms where like faster random projection and so on. And yeah, in general, the idea is to transform a node U in a vector in an embedding space to train some algorithm in general, in this case. So graph feature engineering with GDS, these are some example. We have the degree, the number of nodes that a node is connected. Okay. We have the page rank, communities betweenness, and graph data science on Neo4j. The Neo4j graph data science library help us to create this feature very easily. This is the idea. Then we can also create node embeddings with graph data science. And for instance, we have these three. The NodeShoeVec that is based in a sampling strategies and a model similar to Word2Vec to create embeddings. We have GraphSage that is sample the neighborhood, aggregate the feature information from neighbors and create the new embeddings using some neural networks. And we have fast random projection that the idea is based on a dimensionality reduction technique that create the embeddings for the nodes. Okay, where can you use this feature? Quite simple. Graph neural network that we will see how to load this feature created with Neo4j on a graph neural network and FIST. The Fujitsu SMBits Deep Tensor is a graph neural network developed by us and Fujitsu. And in general, any machine learning algorithm can use these features. In our experience, combining graph data science algorithm, subject matter expert features created using some rules on the graph and so on, can really improve the performances that you can have with graph neural network, machine learning algorithms, and so on. So, the demo that we have this notebook that is based on the DBLP graph. That DBLP is a computer science bibliography website. We adopt a subset of DBLP inspired by the paper MetaPath Aggregator for it's a graph neural network that works on heterogeneous graph. And this dataset containing 14,000 authors, 40 papers, and 9,000 of terms, and 20 publication venues. This is the data model. We have a paper that can contain multiple terms. We have a paper that can be written by different authors, and we have a paper that is published in one conference in general. We have so the offline store. This is a screenshot of the offline store that we used. In general, as we have seen in the slide, FIST assumed to have offline store that is like BigQuery, Redshift, that have the time series information, like created in this case. In this notebook, we have used Timescale DB, and we connected FIST to Timescale DB. We have created using Graph Data Science the embedding, fast random projection embedding, and also the Graph Sage embedding. And we have load this information from Neo4j to Postgres using the Neo4j for two time scale plugin. It's a plugin developed by us. We have load all the features. We have load the features of the paper, the term, and so on. Then we have created the structure of the graph using Deep Graph Library. It's a library to train and to create a graph neural network. And in this case, we have load the structure using a query. With a query, we have load the data from the structured data, so the nodes and relationship into Deep Graph Library. And then we have created all the information. We have defined all the information for FIST to load this data, because we have to tell to FIST where he can find the features, so the fast random projection feature and the Graph Sage feature, and so on. With the feature view, we say to FIST how he can retrieve this data, and at the end we can view all the entities. We have the author, paper, conference, and term. And we have all the features that are the embedding, the fast random projection embeddings for the authors, for the papers, and so on. Then at the end, we load the Firstly, we load the data, so the faster random projection embedding into Deep Graph Library. We can see the embedding loaded. And then we train our graph neural network. And we have a little, we have for sure first defined our graph neural network using Deep Graph Library. And then we have trained it, we can see. We have obtained incredible results, like 99% accuracy, but it's not important. The idea is that we have a workflow to load the data in a graph neural network using FIST. And this is important to use a feature store, because you can iterate through new experiments and new way to create features to train your algorithm in general. And then we repeat this step to train also the graph neural network using the Graph Sage embedding. This is the general idea. Okay. We can go back to the slide. There is a topic that I have not mentioned, that in general the graphs, the graph that we have in Neo4j is very, very big or very dense, and it's a problem for graph neural network, for instance, because if the graph is too dense, the computational graph that the graph neural network needs to create, it's too expensive. So in simple term, you will train your graph neural network very slowly. And if the graph that you have in Neo4j is too big, you can't load it into memory to train the graph neural network. So the idea is, we have seen that the neighborhood sampling is a good approach for dealing with graphs that are too dense. So we sample some nodes from the neighborhood. And a similar approach can be used for graphs too large and too fit into in memory. To compute the embedding, how it works, to compute the embedding of this node, the graph neural network will use two open neighborhood. If the graph neural network has two layers, we'll use the two open neighborhood. And then, as a matter of fact, for each node, the k-open neighborhood can be seen as a mini batch for the graph neural network. And that's the idea. We developed now a Neo4j plugin to perform the heterogeneous graph sampling that is based on a paper published by Microsoft, the heterogeneous graph neural network. And we created this plugin that sample uniformly for each node type to have many information to train the graph neural network. And then with this I can introduce the future work that we want to do. Now we are basing FIST using a Postgres layer, as we have seen. But maybe work directly with a Neo4j database, creating multiple projection and also exploiting better the new feature that Neo4j is offering can be helpful. It's the second point. And the last one is improve the plugin to train graph neural network directly with Neo4j. We want to improve the plugin that I just presented, and we also want to create a feature store for graph neural network. There are no available feature store for graph neural network, and the ideas that I just presented are the starting point to create that feature store. And I just want to present us. I work in Larus. I'm the chapter lead of Larus. We have a long journey with Neo4j. We started 10 years ago. And now we have created our product Galileo.xai with Fujitsu. And that Galileo.xai has many of the ideas that I said integrated. And we have the Fujitsu and SendBits Deep Tensor to allow a subject matter expert or a user, a data scientist, to create his model and his idea directly with our data platform. And that's it. Thank you. If you want to know more, I would be very happy. And we are at the stand with Fujitsu. Thank you so much.